Skin of color has special qualities that affect not only the manifestations of acne, but also the treatment. One of the most important features of acne in skin of color is the darkening of the skin, or staining, called post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. In fact, it's often even more bothersome than the actual acne. I'll discuss both today. Hello, I'm Dr. Neil Schultz, and welcome to DermTV. Most of the acne studies in skin of color are in African American and Hispanic skin. In African American skin, cystic acne is much less common than Caucasian skin, and that may be a result of genetic differences in the structure of the hair follicle. In a study involving about 3,000 patients, in African Americans, a third had active acne, but two-thirds had dark staining from previous outbreaks. And that staining was more bothersome than the active acne to many patients. In the same study in the Hispanic patients, a third, again, had active acne, and half had dark staining. In skin of color, post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation occurs from almost all types of acne lesions, whether they're the inflammatory lesions of pus pimples and red pimples and cysts, or the non-inflammatory blackheads and whiteheads. But in Caucasian, that dark staining usually only occurs from the inflammatory lesions. It was found that in African Americans, the higher use of hair pomades strongly contributes to the increased incidence of blackheads and whiteheads on the forehead at the hairline. You see, as the heat is normally lost from the head, it melts the pomade that coats the hair on the scalp, which then flows invisibly down the hair shaft and onto the forehead, causing clogs right up at the hairline and at the temples. Treatment of acne in skin of color is similar to acne in Caucasian skin, with two important exceptions. Retinoids and benzoyl peroxides, both staples of many types of acne treatment, are often more irritating in skin of color, and that irritation is another source of post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. Accordingly, those two treatments must be used at low doses initially to ensure they don't cause irritation before increasing the dose. And very importantly in skin of color is the treatment of the hyperpigmentation, which requires the usual triad of, first, strict sun protection, but the sunscreen has to be water-based or non-comedogenic to not aggravate the acne. Second, exfoliation. And here the efficacy and gentle nature of buffered glycolics is superior, in my opinion, to retinoids and benzoyl peroxide, which again have a potential for irritation and subsequent hyperpigmentation. And third, a bleach, like a peptide-based product, which doesn't cause halo depigmentation of normal skin surrounding the darkened area. But one more tip. Stay focused and get rid of your active acne, which is causing your staining, before you treat your stains. Regardless of your skin color, acne is very frustrating. Treat it early and regularly, and consult a professional if necessary for the best results. Please join me again at DermTV.com. If you have a question, please send it to me by visiting DermTV.com/question. I'm Dr. Neil Schultz, and thank you for watching today.